are you guys coming out of the spring with a certain momentum that you wanted to feel defensively? I mean, just what is your take? I mean, obviously you got to watch the video and all that kind of stuff. What do you sense about your group?
Yeah, I think coming out and going before the game, obviously we were very vanilla and didn't do anything really. But going into the game, I felt great about how far we had come, what we've accomplished, how much we got installed, how the players took to it. I mean, it was as good or better than I could have wished.
Far left, Stephen Deans, Cleveland.com. Basically, it just gave a chance for those corners to cover, especially with Jordan and Josh Camden. He's been out with Cameron Brown. How did you think they performed today?
I was very pleased. You know, we're continuing to work on playing close to people, throwing punches, being aggressive with our coverage, and that may be a little bit of a change for them. You know, and they're adapting to it all the time. And you know, we're going against the best receiving corps in the country, so I think it's going to continue to be a reason for them to get better, because what they see every day in practice, and we're going to continue coaching aggressive coverage.
I'm going to go over here to the far right, Austin Ward, Letterman Road.
I don't want to make too much out of one maybe spring game, and one scrimmage. Ty Stokes was really seemed to be flying around in the secondary for you. I know he's got a black stripe up as well. What has his camp been like? What do you see for him moving forward here?
Kai has had a good spring. But yeah, without watching the film, I thought he had a great game just because he showed up and flashed it and looked like he rose to the occasion. You know, what you worry about with a young guy is the bright lights. And I mean, he looked like it was no problem for him. He really stepped up. So I'm looking at good things for him. I mean, I liked him all along, but I was impressed today.
Over here to the far left, Bill Landis, The Athletic.
Jim, I guess a lot of defensive line depth, but I assume at some point you want to settle on who are actually the first four guys kind of in that rotation. What do you think of the second year guys with JT, Jack, Tyler, like Hall, and maybe the push they're giving the older guys who have been here a little longer as you're trying to figure out that rotation?
I love those guys. I love every single one of them you mentioned. I love the depth. You didn't ask, but I don't really care who starts, to be honest with you, because we're going to play a lot of guys up front, and I want them fresh, and I want them hungry, and the more, the better. And that whole group you mentioned, they could easily be starters. You know, I think they're that good. They've had that kind of spring. So I see us playing a lot of guys up there.
Deep right, Brendan Gulick, Buckeyes Now on Sports Illustrated.
And Jim, it's pretty clear that you like a lot of the young talent you have in the room, and many of them played well today. King Power, CJ Hicks, Andre, Denzel, Kai, so on and so forth. In terms of young players' development, what is most important for them at this stage of the game and at this time of the year so they can be healthy and ready in September?
Yeah. So young guys, to me, as I've seen it, they always have to learn how to take care of their bodies. You know, they spend their whole high school career just being great because they're talented, and now they get to the top of college football, and all of a sudden they have nutritionists and the best strength staff in the country, and now they have to sleep and go to school. So to me, it's just all about taking care of their bodies, realizing that something clicks in their mind eventually to say, hey, you're an Olympic athlete, you need to train, take care of yourself like an Olympic. You see that light switch come on a lot with those young guys. We got a lot of talented guys, and we'll continue to work with them. When they get done with exams, take time off, come back. We'll be working with them, and we'll be working with them all summer because I think a lot of them can play for us.
Just following up on that, I mean, that group of guys, who among them is most emotionally intelligent, the guys that most recognize when they need more help with nutrition, they need better sleep? Who has taken good strides with that?
I don't think I know enough yet to comment on that. You know, I think I need to continue to learn more about them as people, really dive into their lives. You know, I think after the last couple months, I've been just pushing, install on top of them and on top of the coach. coaches that I think I'll learn more on. I need to really invest more time into who they are, how they're living.